Oh, it's going to be finding out in just a moment or two. Let's zoom out and take a look at the team comps. It's going to be the Ornn, traditional, standard, slash, safe. Ornn versus Sett, how many times have
we
seen?
Spoiler for everyone watching at home, we're going to be very focused on the Mad Lions in this early game because they're the ones that need to make things happen. Right now, you can already see the wave is pushing in towards Karzy. He's allowing it to sit here, so Jankos is here to try and break the freeze, but Shadow is waiting in the wings, and Mickey is quite low. No flash on caps also.
Also, Humanoid backed away from Wonder the moment the play started. The Flag and Drag lands. One, two, three teleports in the bottom lane. Caps goes down. First blood to Karzy. He gets himself another. That's a third for the Mad Lions. And they build up a 1,000 gold lead already.
Two know how to execute on these teleport plays. And they teleport a top lane LeBlanc down too. Because why not? They're able to find the punish there. And some damage onto Jankos, who has to flash away. Karzy's going crazy under the tower. And he finds the trade. Kills just an execute as well. They're getting everything.
They are executing well on them. It is working out. It's the lull states where they are not making that happen, and we're seeing one right now.
Okay, so there's a reply back. Arome, he's used the flash much earlier, lost the TP. Now Kaiser throws himself into the mix. G2 have got themselves one kill. They're looking for a second. That's a gigantic shield that keeps Kaiser alive. Oh, he steps right back in. Where's the support? What was that?
What is he doing?
That was the mistake that you cannot afford to do of the game. Now we need to see how do they push this lead further. Perks has swapped in the mid lane. He's now gone to top. And it looks to me as the Humanoid is either just warding up or he's leaving that lane to match the Ornn. And I want to keep tracking how these lane assignments play out, because it has such a huge impact on how the next few minutes go.
Yeah, we'll keep seeing the dancing for a while as Kaiser hops over the wall to find out Jankos here.
Yeah, they do indeed. And that should just be an easy kill. Jankos, no flash available, no ultimate either. Drop a flag on his head. Will it land? That's the question.
No! He's alive! What? And now Kaiser's gonna die for it! Unreal!
I do not believe that he got away with it! Four members of G2 Esports going for the dive. If any of the CC can get interrupted, the knockup doesn't happen. But look, easy catch onto Kaiser. He steps into enemy territory. Now it's a 3v4, but Mad Lions are split. Cataclysm comes down as Karzy rocks up to the fight. The Cataclysm locked him out. It's a 1v1 trade as Kaiser and Caps go to Karzy on this Ezreal. 350 gold bounty to his name. Here comes Jankos. He wants himself a new pair of shoes. And Arome is going to get run down. It's just a matter of time. Barrel comes back. I need to stop saying it, because what I think are obvious kills, twice this game have not been obvious kills.
Don't really start to care. For now, it's just been about the farm game when he's been putting a couple of tough matchups so far in this one. A lot of jungle attention been thrown his way too, but gotta finish this one off first, and Mad Lions are doing well to stay ahead in the gold even after...
Mad Lions have started to falter, and this time around Kaiser escapes with his life. There was no damage support backing up. Window of opportunity where Mad Lions want to be ahead, and G2 Esports just won't give them that chance. Look at that. I mean, what are you supposed to do? You cannot go anywhere when G2 commit to the...
down on knocking out the bottom lane turret. Again, I feel like Mad Lions have to just, like, look for something big now, right? You have both teleports up between your soul laners, so maybe look for a flank play here. That's going to be the call.
It will be indeed. Remember, ultimates have been used in that previous engage. Kaiser goes for the flash pullback. We'll be able to get the kill now onto Perks. And now all of a sudden, Wonder's the target. Mickey's going to arrive here. Quickness is available to him. He can use it to buy some time. He does. Gets the two-man knockup. That buys enough time for Wonder to run away. Jankos has arrived. He's got the Gragas barrel available to him. We'll throw out at least a slow from the queue and flash over the wall. But that is...
They probably would have gotten much more off of that play, but instead called down a lot as Wonder looks for the turn on Arome.
A lot of damage onto Arome. That's a flash committed as well. Wonder has managed to get the knockup. That allows Perks to enter the fray. It will find one kill, and Mad Lions can't get a reply back. Up will not connect, and Mickey's forced to fly back to safety. But it is still Mad Lions maintaining control, as well as now the tower advantage.
And you're looking for G2 minus Perks. That gives them the ability to execute in the 5v5 and to target to punch out, unless Arome just gets picked.
Oh my word! Just destroyed, couldn't go anywhere, locked against the wall.
Two items right now against an Essence Reaver. Mad Lions are just going to win the fight, so G2, instead of wasting time in the bot lane river, they're going to trade topside. They're going to pick up...
A little while away, of course, we need to control some more waves before we get to placing all those wards down. But for the time being, Jankos is going to make a small play on a Rome. Actually, commit
it's
the
not
flash.
A small play. That's a big one.
It was when the flash came in. And a Rome's just going to get run down. Yeah, he gets knocked up into the air. He throws the flash
Why are we
out.
Flashing?
And the bullet time comes down as well. G2 are trying to break a Rome's mental. He is 1-6-3.
Yeah, everything was super telegraphed there as well. You actually saw both teams taking major resets. Mad Lions recalled 4, G2 recalled 3, and Aroma is the one that stays. Matters a lot. He just got a sorcery elixir. He's going to look for the one shot on Yankos right here.
Oh, he's going to get the damage so far. The belly pop comes out. Not going to be able to get the kill just yet. Flash over the wall. It's already a shutdown, though, as Kazi's on the board. Three members of G2 locked inside the Cataclysm. I think they jumped in there with Shadow. Now, all of a sudden, that's a shutdown. Yes, Arome's got it. That's what Mad Lions need. Kaiser's running for his life. Turns back in. Steps forward. Mickey jumps out. Flies back. Perks has already used the ultimate, doesn't have a lot to follow it up, and Kazi stays alive the entire time. Arome finds himself 2 kills that fight. 5 home a win.
Well, it was a perfect fight right there for them. We said they needed to get a little bit creative. Well, that comes through Humanoid finishing off the Void Staff and saying, and Wonder, you're just going to want to recall there, buddy. You don't want any part of this.
And remember, all Mad Lions need is 1 kill. If they do, it just sets them up for a fairly safe Baron play. Wonder's TP gets interrupted. He took a shot. He took a chance. And he will be donating a kill. He got caught out. No, that wasn't a donation. Mad Lions earned that kill. They pushed him out of mid lane. And they managed to find the kill. Humanoid blows up Yankos.
Spawn. So we are in a position where Mad Lions very likely can close out this game because the last few fights have gone so far their way.
Yep. They've got all the tools they need. All of a sudden, G2 Esports are trying to make a play. Perks will get teleported on. And Arome can look to shut him down. There's the knockup, as well as the stun. Dominus is ticking. Perks does a lot to stay alive, but it's simply not enough. Humanoid gets himself a kill onto Caps completely unaided. And it's good to see now the rest of the squad stepping up, as now they're knocking on G2's base.
Yeah, they're all the way in here. It doesn't seem like internet's the only problem G2 has, but they're going to try and turn around onto Humanoid here.
Well, Humanoid does get blown up, but at what cost? The inhibitor tower is down. Now Kaiser's in a little bit of trouble. Gets knocked backwards for a moment or two. Body slam comes out. The shield by so much time that allows Kaiser to slam dunk Yankos down. Blast cone comes out and Kazi continues to take them on a wild goose chase. He's just spitting out True Shot Barrage after True Shot Barrage. Arcane shift forward.
And just clean up even more on this map, because right now Wonder is pushed way too far forward.
All credits to the Mad Lions. They came into game 3 picking themselves a team composition that had in itself a timing window they needed to execute. They had lost 2 games in a row because of poor execution at different stages of the game. And this rookie squad, staring down the barrel of a 0-3, they find a way to build nearly a 10,000 gold lead, get Baron, get Dragon Soul, and now they're pushing into the base of G2. They have still got their backs against the wall. They need to win 2 more games if they want another shot at Fnatic. But for now, it's about killing the Nexus. I asked a doctor about the best way for Mad Lions to win the game, and he just said, kill the Nexus, bro. And that's what Mad Lions are trying to do.
They're killing everything first, though, starting with the bot lane inhibitor right now. Mid lane also exposed, and G2 just can't find a fight. Wonder is going to be spawning, but they're going to be down 3 inhibitors before that even happens. This might just close out here if they decide to pull the trigger.
It feels that way. Shadow was pulling a distraction over on the western side of the base, and Shadow now comes down with the Cataclysm, the showstopper from Kaiser into a 2-man pull. Humanoid is dancing on the flanks, and so is Kazi. Bullet time used to try and stop the fight, but now there's a million minions pushing onto the Nexus. Mad Lions will not go down 0-3. Instead, they force us into another game, and they prove to G2 they can fight back. Get themselves a couple extra kills, pad those stats, Mad Lions, as they take down G2 1-2.
How about that? Mad Lions just exploded in the game right now.